डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
हेलो एवरीवन, आई डॉक्टर दर्शना दलवाड़ी इज वेलकमिंग यू ऑल टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ साइबर सिक्योरिटी फ्रॉम द चैतन्य स्टूडियो ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। इन टुडेज लेक्चर लर्नर्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द एडवांस परसिस्टेंट थ्रेट्स APTs एंड साइबर किल चेन। In previous lectures, we have discussed about the understanding of problem, what type of problems we are facing when we are having APTs. Then after we discuss about the vectors, attack vectors we have, then traditional APTs, then after the techniques and tools advanced APTs and the cyber kill chain. Different phases are there in which the input of one phase will be the output of another phase. Means right now suppose we have started the first phase, then as the first phase starts, it will give some output. Whatever output we have in the first step will be the input of the second step. So that we have already discussed. Today we are going to see about that steps. First steps we have, see, this is what we have already seen. I am just briefing you that we are having 7 steps: reconnaissance, then weaponization, delivery, exploitation, installation, command and control, and actions on objective. Now in reconnaissance, what we are doing, actually we are gathering the information. Then 2 types of reconnaissance we have: active and passive. Then after that we are having weaponization. Whatever output we have from the reconnaissance, that will be the input of weaponization. Up to this we have discussed. Now whatever output we will get from here, that will be the input of the third step, that is exploit. Now in exploit, what we are having, exploit is a part of the weapon which facilitates RAT means what? Remote access trojan, to execute in the target machine. It uses system or software vulnerabilities to drop and execute a RAT. What it will use? It will use the software or system vulnerability by which it can execute a RAT or it can drop a RAT. The major objective to use exploits is to evade the detection. Exploits can be related to MS Office, means we may have the file which will have the extension as doc or PPT or Excel file, which can be identified from its CVE, that is Common Vulnerabilities and Exposure Number. One CVE number will be there by which we can identify the exploits. Some examples are given to you of CVE. First one we have, that is CVE 2017-11882, or we can have CVE 2014-9165. These are just the examples. You may have different CVEs. Then after, there are methods which do exist in which the target system can be accessed without using exploit. They are very unreliable in these times as the organization has already set up multiple security layers. In today's time, the organizations are setting multiple securities, because of which this type of exploits are not reliable exploits. So they are doing the usage of RAT. Embedding RAT or an exploit code inside the legitimate file will be easier to evade the detection. Because the organizations are having more security layers, they are not able to evade the detection. So what they are doing, they are embedding the RAT or trying to exploit the code inside the legitimate file. Legitimate file means authorized file which is having some accesses. In such files, they are adding their code and trying to exploit the code with the help of such files, which will help them to evade the detection. In some cases, multiple exploits are used to create a payload using the exploit kits. Some cases are there in which only one exploit is not enough. They need to have more than one exploits. So they are creating multiple exploits, which will help them to create a payload. And this they will do with the help of exploit kits, which provides the exploit code for different softwares. By the help of these multiple exploits, whatever output they are getting, that will be the code only, that will called as the exploit code, which will be used as a code for exploitation in different softwares. Then operating system level exploits use kernel level exploitations or exploits the devices with the help of device driver itself to perform remote or local code execution. We may have operating system level exploits, or we may have the device driver exploits. If it is operating system level exploit, then it will use the kernel level exploits, and if it is device driver, then itself it will use the remote or local code execution. Network level exploit can also be there. So if network level exploits are there, then it try to exploit network devices or protocols which will help them to perform the privilege escalation. This is what we are having in exploit. Whatever output we get from this step will be the next step's input, that is the input of delivery. Next step we have, that is delivery. So output of exploit will be the input of delivery. It is a critical part of the cyber kill chain, which is responsible for an efficient and effective cyber attack. In most of the cyber attack, it is mandatory to have some user interactions, such as using email attachments, drive by downloads, USB or browser based attack. Now, when we are having such type of cyber attack, automatically it is not performed. In some cases, it gets automatic execution, but in most of the cases, we need some user interaction. User interaction can be anything, like if we are having any email attachment. If you remember or recall, then we have seen that when APTs are there, in APT vector cycle, we have seen that if APT is there, then you need some event or you need some entry point from where the code will enter. As an entry point, we were having email, then we were having the USB, right? We were having the files. So if something is there by which the user is interacting, then only the input will be given by the user to the code which they want to exploit. They means the attacker. Getting? So what we have to do? We need some user interaction. Interaction can be anything. It can be a use of email attachment, it can be a download, or it can be a simple external device, USB drive or mobile connection, or any other connection by which the transformation is done, for which the initial target information is necessary for deciding which method will be useful. This can be varied according to the target. Whatever the target is, according to that, the method of interaction will be different. There are some attacks which are performed without user interaction. I said you that in some cases, we may have the exploitation by itself, but in most of the cases we need user interaction. So some attacks are there which are performed without user interaction, and when without user interaction we have the attacks, at that time we have exploitation in network devices or services, such as CVE 2014-33006, then CVE 2014-9583. These are the CVEs what we have discussed already. So in such type of CVE, we were having exploit in network devices and in and exploitation in services, in which no user interaction is required. After that, in delivery, we can also say that this is the high risk phase. It leaves the digital footprints behind. And as we know that when we have this APT, they are trying to leave any clue. They do not want to have any clue behind them. But delivery is the stage in which they can have the footprints by which they can be tracked. So most of the attacks are performed in an anonymous way using paid services. So what they are doing? To overcome this limitation, they are using paid services and as anonymous, without giving their original information, they are using it and trying to attack. Successfully targeting the user in the first attempt cannot be guaranteed. It is not so that in the first attempt only they will target their mission. In such cases, the attacker will gain all information due to which the first attempt was failed and will make sure that in the second attempt, it successfully exploits target machine. Suppose this is the case where in first attempt, the attacker is not able to hack the information or not able to steal the information. So what they will do? They will gain all the information of that attack. Each and everything related to that first attempt. And from that, they will analyze, they will understand that where they have done mistake, so that that same thing cannot be repeated in the second attempt. In some cases where one delivery method is not sufficient, multiple delivery methods are used. Some cases are there in which only one delivery method is not sufficient. So, in such cases, you can have multiple delivery methods. Next stage we have, that is exploitation. Once the successful delivery of the weapon is done, see here, whatever delivery phase we have discussed, it was all about the weapons delivery, means we can say the codes delivery, which they want to include in organization. So, after the delivery of that weapon, next step we have, that is exploitation. It means to execute or trigger the exploit on the target side. The goal is to silently install or execute the exploit. The main goal of exploit is what? Silently installing the code and executing it to generate the exploit in the organization. There are certain conditions need to be matched for this to work, such as user must be using software or services for which the exploit is created. Now see, when the exploitation is there, at that time it needs some conditions which must be provided. Which type of conditions are there? For whatever target, for whatever services they have created the exploit code, that services must be used. Who will use? The user. Or suppose they have targeted the software, then that software must be used. So who will use? The user. So some conditions are there which need to be matched when such type of exploits are generated. For whatever software or services it is created, that type of software or services must be used by the user. Next, operating system should not be updated with the latest patches which will fail the exploit to work. Second thing it required is what? The operating system which we are having, it should not be updated. If it is getting updated, then it will find the patches from where it can have the exploit in the organization. the update which we are getting in operating system is actually what? It is updating about all the things, means whatever type of viruses, new viruses are introduced, what type of new trojans are introduced, such type of information it is providing. So it should not be updated, otherwise whatever new things they are trying, that will get caught and they will not be able to steal the information. And last, antivirus software should not be able to detect the payload. Here you can say antivirus software should not be up to the mark, means up to the date, means we know that when we are having antivirus softwares, at that time it gets updated automatically and it is showing you that the last date of updation. So if such type of antivirus softwares you are using in your organization and this APT is there, then this will protect that organization to get harmed by the APT. So this should be there, this condition should be there, so that only you can have the exploitation in your organization. After that, next step we have, that is installation. Now in installation, what we are having, in traditional methods of the infections will not work in which the machine is infected with the links created in the startup folder or creating the registry of the file to run in a startup. As of end user protection mechanisms has grown. In traditional one, what we were having as an installation, we were having the links which were created in the startup folders, or we can say it was having a registry of the file which was running in the startup of your software. So such type of things we are not having nowadays. It will not work. Traditional method will not work with your exploits. So as of end user protection mechanisms has grown. Modern malware is multi-staged and they heavily depend on the droppers and downloaders to deliver the malware. In modern malware, or we can say in model exploits, we are not having such type of simple registry file or simple link, say, which we will get executed in startup folder, but instead of that we have the downloaders and droppers which will help to deliver the malware in your system. They are dependent on such things. After that we are having command and control. Now after successfully triggering the malware, the important part of the remote attack is command and controls. It is called as CNC, or we can say C and C. CNC gives the instruction to the compromised machine. There are mainly three different types of communication structures, such as centralized structure, peer to peer, and latest social network based communication structure. As we know, centralized structure means we are talking about the communication structure, so means how the communication is done in our network. Centralized structure means one center will be there from where the different peers are getting the communication or getting the information, sending or receiving. Then after we have peer to peer. Peer to peer means one machine, one peer is connected with the another peer, sending the information from there and receiving the information from there. And latest we are having, that is social network based communication structure. These are the three main types of communication structure. Now when CNC is there, in it communication traffic analysis is a traditional approach to detect the communication pattern in the target machine. In CNC means command and control, in that the communication traffic analysis is a traditional approach which will help to help to detect the communication pattern in the target machine. How the communication pattern is there means in which manner the machine is getting communicated. Whatever target machine is there, its communication pattern they are analyzing. Malware authors tend to use new techniques in which it is difficult to separate it from the legitimate traffic of the network to make it more anonymous. what the malware authors are doing, they are using new techniques in which it is difficult to separate it from the legitimate traffic. Legitimate traffic means authorized traffic. When we are having any network at that time, authorized files will be transferred in different way, and means their behavior will be different, and unauthorized files will behave separately. So when this type of malwares we have at that time, what they are doing? They are using new techniques which will make them similar to the legitimate traffics, by which they will not be able to separate that these type of files are unauthorized. They will behave same like the authorized traffic, means authorized files or authorized data. And trying to make this type of malware files or malwares more anonymous, which will help them to hide their identity, because of which they will not be able to caught by the organization's security measures. So this is what we are having in command and control. After that, next step we have, that is actions on objective. Now in the last phase, the attacker tries to achieve the final goal, which is to exfiltrate the data from the compromised machine by giving instructions from the command and control server. In the last phase, we have seen that attacker is trying to achieve the final goal, which is to exfiltrate the data from the compromised machine by giving instruction from the command and control server. So this is what we are having in actions on objective. Whatever objective they have, on that what type of actions they are taking, that is what we are having in actions on objective. After this, we are having the summing of whole lecture, whatever we have discussed. Now see, first thing we have seen, that is the life cycle of APT, how the APT is working, from where it will start, what are different type of vectors we are using, what are the different tools and techniques we have for APT, then what measures we can take to make the awareness about the APT in organization, how we can make them aware, how we can explain the users of the organization about the APT, then the different threats and attack vectors which are part of the APT. We have seen that when we are talking about APT, at that time number of type of attack threats are there, as well as attack vectors are there, which are part of APTs. So how it is helpful in APT and how they are used, that we have discussed. Then tools and techniques which are used in the APT attack. As we have seen that these APTs are advanced threats. Traditional attacks they can use, traditional threats the attackers can use, but with it they are using some advanced techniques, some advanced tools. We have already seen the tools and techniques which they can use, so we are not discussing in detail here, but we are just revising that what is discussed. So advanced tools and techniques are there which they can use with the traditional one and generate the new APT, or we can say that by using such new tools and techniques they can generate their own APT. It is not so that every time the new APT will be there. They may have the traditional threat. In that they are doing some modifications with the help of new tools and techniques, and after having this that modifications, they are getting some new code, some new malware. So this is what we can have in APT attack also. And we have seen the different phases of the cyber kill chain along with the other technical details. Here, as we have seen, the cyber kill chain we are having. Before cyber kill chain, we discuss about the APT cycle, APT vector cycle, right? So, in cyber kill chain, we have seen different steps which will help us to see the attacks stages from reconnaissance to exfiltration. From starting to end, it is showing us different steps. 7 steps are there, which already we have seen, which is showing us that the input of one step is becoming the output of previous step. First step is reconnaissance, in which we are gathering the information. After that, it gets in second stage, and so on. After the completion of all the 7 step, we will have action on objective stage. This was the last stage of cyber kill chain. So this is the end of our today's lecture. Next thing we will start in next lecture. So learners, thank you for today. Adhyayah paramam tapah.